What level of privilege do you have to be in society to think that the biggest problem is fucking milk? Boomers, by the way, it's the first generation that has a shit ton of life experience and no wisdom. Like, they're like, I've been on this planet a long time. It's like, and you ruined it. Shut the fuck up, half of you. Not all of you, but a lot of you should just pipe down. Just go out quietly. You destroy. It's like you inherit a house. You burn the house down. Just leave quietly. Just exit quietly. Nobody in the natural world is handing each other trophies. There's no bear getting up at a podium and going, I am a voice for the voiceless.
Do you think that there's another Epstein Island out there right now?
12. Better. Newer. Yeah. No, the kids go down a slide into a furnace.
And Charles Gasparino, you know, that guy from CNBC, is like, yeah, you're always in the tombs. It's underfunded. It's underfunded. The people that work there, they're not that bright. You know who's not that bright? You. You're not that bright, Charles. Stop posting libertarian memes if you live with your mother. Stop talking about how bad socialism is if you live with your mother. Socialism is bankrupted. Will you shut up?
Are you a centrist?
I think I believe in pedophile cults and lizard people. I think that's centrist. I think that's in the center.
I was in subprime mortgages. I was dumb enough to sell the product to myself. I sold a house to myself. You're not supposed to get so drunk you scam yourself. I scammed myself. Can we stop giving murderers all the airtime in this country now? You got to murder someone in a small town to get a show. Now, I'm sorry I didn't kill someone in a small American town. Because everyone wants to sit around and watch murder all day in a small town where people go, oh, you know, I'm so down and earthy and, oh, it's just shook up the whole town. What did you drink from college to what? You were to what? To
like 19 to like 25.
Yeah. Yeah. I would say that was me too. I think I was like 19 to 25 because I was drugs from 13 to 20 and of course from 20 to 25 as well. Imagine going to New York City, the greatest city in the world, in my opinion. And I'm right. I mean, London's a goth nightmare. The food sucks. Shut up. Shanghai, that'll have its time. It's coming. Don't worry about it. You'll have the next century. Let me have the past one. Thank you. I believed in the Bush administration. And then I stopped doing cocaine. The word taping of the Tonight Show, to me, is synonymous with the word inoperable. Like, be hearing it's inoperable. You know, drink wine. Take pills. Take pills and drink wine. Get drunk. OD in your bed. Die. Do something adult for once. Be a fucking adult. It's going to be exciting. We're going to see Jimmy's going to come out. Maybe he'll have a field piece where he goes to the Olive Garden with Post Malone or Cardi B. And they can sit in the Olive Garden where people have worked 16 hours to make a living. And they soak their feet every night because they swell because they're on them all day. And they're taking amphetamines to just keep doing it and keep fucking answering the questions that fat tourists from Ohio have about penne alla vodka. Do something adult. Like, get a drinking problem and lose your kids. That's what adults do. They don't fucking smoke pot and talk about how disappointing the new Star Wars was. Lose your firm. Snort your house. Destroy yourself with pharmaceuticals. They have to do that, and they're all drugged up, and they can barely have a cigarette break. And when they do, they go outside, and it's just a cacophony of New York City blaring horns and ambulances, and they go back into the Olive Garden. And then they have to hear from their manager that, well, you got to look good today because Jimmy's coming in with Post Malone. I smoke to go to sleep. Well, deal with your demons. Make peace with the monster under the bed. Defeat him. Be him. But there's got to be a guy that considers having a Travis Bickle moment. There's got to be a guy that thinks of throwing a tour of Italy on the table and then lunging at Fallon. There's got to be one of those chefs in the back that's had quite enough of this shit. DMT, it doesn't matter. I take DMT. I go to the other realm. I'll try to sell the aliens condos. I'll convert them. They'll be like, we're all hypersound. Be like, will you shut the fuck up? Do you want a stunning estate? Yes or no?
They're more capable. Like, all the shit that they've pulled, the CIA, all these people, they're just too good. They're good. They've beat me. They're going to win. They're going to win. The CIA is going to beat you.
It's like Scorsese. How about stepping out of your fucking comfort zone? Make a movie about black trans women. Why don't you impress me? Stop making movies about these fucking goons. We get it. How about you show that you got a little fucking range? Make a movie about babies.
Right, but you don't want them taking away your rights and closing in on your email account.
They're going to do it. They're going to do it anyway.
Are they? Are you
what
sure?
What are you going to do?
Don't take my rights. Send.
What the fuck matter? This 1950s horse shit where everything was so good, but we were, you know, sicking dogs on black kids trying to go to school. Or on a show like The View, where they go out and it's just five women screaming about politics. Because there's nothing worse than The View in terms of, like, there are so many brilliant women out there. None of them are on The View. None of them have gone near the set of The View. Yeah, I mean, Troy Baker, like, again, these people have dementia. These are people who, like, should not be allowed out of the house. They have a national platform. I mean, it is crazy. They have no idea. These people have never read, like, a book.
Why doesn't The View have any trans women on it?
Great point. It has a lot of women that look trans, but none of them. It has a lot of second and third takes. After a drink, you'd go, huh? But it doesn't have a ton of, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, she's going to be sacrificed. If Bill Gates released this virus, I mean, what are you going to do? What are you going to do? Tweet about it? What, do you have a militia? You ready to go? What, you got a few guns? In the back, you shoot at your tree in Georgia?
I knew it. I sensed it.
Look, she's chewing it up. Pause that. She's like, you see, he sensed it. These people are frauds. What is wrong with you? They are actors. They are frauds. She's claiming to be a bagel. And then she's going to hang out with Ilhan Omar and read Mein Kampf. They don't believe in anything. You people put your stock, she's hot. If she looked like me, she'd be another loser socialist in her basement right now, talking about Kapital. But she looks like her, so she's on television every 36 seconds. You're going to let these people run your life? You're investing in this? Or Trump, who's like dancing with Epstein like this for 30 years and then decides that he doesn't know who he is? My father allowed me to watch because he allowed me to watch most things in the 90s. That was his style of parenting. He said, if you want to watch it, you can watch it. The movie Seven? Sure. Not a problem. Whatever you want to watch. You want to watch Dead Man Walking? You want to see Sean Penn get lethal injection? What are you, seven? You'll enjoy this. It's playing up the block. I don't want to pay for a babysitter. I want to go watch Casino. You ever seen someone get buried alive? You're about to. Handle it. Handle it like a man.
Here's the problem. Most people don't care. They don't want these rights. They actually don't. Most people don't give a shit about their rights. They want pizza. They want chicken wings. They want fucking soda. They want cheap credit. They want to go on a cruise once a year. They don't give a shit about their rights.
Cruise.
They don't care. They want Netflix and they want, you know, garlic knots. And that's what it is. They just enjoy like putting something warm and doughy in their mouth, vegging out and fucking waking up the next day and go, shit, I'm here again. And they're the happiest people.
They like to get drunk and go boating.
That's it. They like to get fucked up and go out on the lake. Go out on the lake and get railed up. And like, yeah. And it's fun. What, are you going to sit around all day worry about what DARPA's doing? It's like, the fuck kind of life is that? Grill a burger, it's over. I mean, enjoy it.
Yeah,
it's the end, and the end's not that bad. As ends go, this end happens to be hilarious, and there's still food in the food stores.